Hi friends, welcome back to this React.js advanced concept series. In the last video, I have explained about use context in depth. In this video, I actually want to talk about use callback. But I feel if I cover React.memo before use callback, it will be easier for me to explain use callback. So let me talk about React.memo in this video. Let's start. React.memo is a higher order component in React that allows us to optimize functional components by preventing unnecessary rerenders. React.memo helps improve the performance of our app by memoizing, or in other words, caching the result of a component's render. When the component's props don't change, React skips the rerender and returns the memoized output. By default, React.memo only rerenders a component if its props have changed. It performs a shallow comparison to check whether the props have been updated. Instead of theory, let me explain how React.memo works using a simple example. In this application, I have two states in my demo component, count and message. I have a button to update this count state, and I have a text box to update this message state. And so, if any of these state is changed, this component rerenders. And I'm also having another child component called counter. I'm using this in my demo component and passing this count status props. In counter component, I'm getting this props and showing here. I have also put one console log to see whether my counter component is getting rerendered. Okay, when I click this button, this count state is getting changed, and as we are passing this count state to this counter component through props, this counter component is also getting rerendered. But when I change the value in this text box, this message state alone is getting changed. As we are not passing this state to the counter component, we may expect that this counter component should not rerender. But ideally, as this parent component re-renders because of this state update, this will trigger a re-render in this child component as well. React.memo helps us in solving this problem. Let me wrap this counter component inside React.memo. Like this. Now if I click this button, we can see the counter component is re-rendering because as this counter props is changed, it has to re-render. But if I change this state using the text box, now we can see this counter component is not rerendering. This is how React.memo helps us to avoid unnecessary rerenders and improve the performance. Okay, let me show you another scenario. Here I have two states, first count and second count. I have two buttons to change these states. And I have a detail component to which I am passing the first count state. So now, if I change the first count state, the detail component will re-render because we are passing this state as props and it is getting changed. But if I change the second count state, the detail component will not re-render because we are using React.memo and we are not passing this state as props to this detail component. In case, if we are not using React.memo, we can see now this detail component is re-rendering on changing this state also. Okay, let me put the React.memo back. And so, when we click this button, we are seeing the detail component is not re-rendering. Okay, now let me have an object. And let me pass this object to the detail component through props. Let me test it now. I'm going to click this button. What will happen? We can see the detail component is getting re-rendered. That is because when I click this button, the second count state is getting updated and so this component will re-render. And so a new person object will be created. And as we are passing this person object as props to this component, this will re-render because according to this component, this is going to be a new object. Even though we are not changing any value in this person object and also we are not using this person object inside this component, the re-render is happening. This is an unnecessary re-render. So, we should be careful while passing the props. We should pass only the needed props. Okay, let me show you another scenario. Here I have a state and two buttons to update the properties of this state. And I have a person component to which I am passing these properties as props. In the person component, I am getting these properties as props and showing them here. Okay, let me test it. If I click any of these buttons, we can see this person component is re-rendering. Because we are passing both of these states as props And so if we are changing any of these states, this person component will rerender. But in case there is a requirement to pass both the states as props to this person component, but this person component should rerender only when the name property is changed. It should not rerender when the age property is changed. How can we achieve this? In React.memo, we can pass a second function in which we can pass the previous props and next props, and inside the function, we can compare and return that result like this. Now, if we test, we can see the person component is not rerendering when we change the age state, and it is getting rerendered when we change the name state. This is how we can do custom comparison and rerender the child component. Okay, even though React.memo is helping us in optimization, there are certain scenarios in which we should avoid using it. Sometimes our component will be simple. It may not have heavy computations and it will render quickly. For this type of component, using React.memo might add unnecessary overhead because it adds an extra comparison step to compare props during every render, which itself takes some processing time. Sometimes our parent component rarely updates the props. In this scenario, we don't need React.memo in the child component. Sometimes when we pass complex objects or functions as props, React.memo is ineffective because React.memo uses shallow comparison and checks for reference. But these objects are recreated in every render. This re-renders the child component as well. Sometimes our parent component re-renders frequently due to state or prop changes. It may still cause the child components to re-render. Here we should avoid using React.memo so that we can avoid checking whether the child component should render or not. React.memo doesn't prevent re-renders when context value changes. So if our component is consuming values from React's context API, there is no use in using React.memo. If our component has side effects like API calls, timers, or even listeners that rely on updating or recalculating this on every render, wrapping it with React.memo might lead to defects. By keeping these considerations in mind, we can make better decisions about when to use React.memo. Hope you understood. That's all for today. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.